Good day. Welcome to 50 Plates of Food with Chef Willie from Passion for Cooking. My name is Deborah, and today's dish is Mexican short rib tacos. Chef Willie, over to you.
I'm going to show you today how to make the ultimate braised beef short rib tacos. To start off with, we have a beautiful piece of short rib. It's about three ribs. It's about 600 grams. South African's best. And this we're gonna braise in the oven for about 5 hours and give it a nice dry rub. For the dry rub, we have salt, paprika powder, garlic powder, black pepper, and dark sugar. We're gonna mix all these ingredients together. And to that, we're gonna add some cumin. And the cumin seeds I toasted before, so the flavor comes really out. And then we're gonna crush them until it is a powder to get the full flavor out of it. It tastes and smells fantastic. So you dig in with your hands and make it with our piece of meat. You rub that spice in all the cavities so all the flavor comes nice into the meat. Get the bottom and rub that spice fully into the spice mix. Place it into a braising pan, add a little bit more of your rub on top. So what we add to the beef is a mirepoix, and a mirepoix is just very simple. You take a nice carrot and peel our carrot. We take two stalks of celery, and we take an onion, and we clean the onion, take the peel off. And then we'll cut the onion in coarse pieces. Doesn't have to be too fine, because later on, when it comes out of the oven, it will be nicely cooked. And for the carrot, cut off the tip and cut the carrot in quite big chunks. We need about 3/4 of a carrot. Then this vegetable, put it around your beef short rib in your braising dish. And as last thing, we're gonna add, and they are now fantastic in season, some sweet peppers to give it a nice sweet tang to it. And for those who like it a little bit more spicy, you can add a jalapeno pepper or even a serrano pepper if you like to put a little bit of a fire into this dish. And the same for the peppers. Cut them coarse and add them to your vegetables. On top of that, we're gonna pour fresh squeezed orange juice and cover all of that with tin foil. And put this in the oven for about 5 hours at 200 degrees Celsius. And to stuff the tacos, we're gonna use a pico de gallo, which is a tomato salsa, Mexican tomato salsa, and a nice creamy guacamole to do with our short rib. I'm gonna show you how to make the pico de gallo. You take nice ripe tomatoes, And we're going to de-seed them in the middle, so we're going to use only the meat. And then we'll take the seed out. For about four nice big tacos to fill, you need about two tomatoes. And then we cut these tomatoes in small dice. I'm not gonna use all of it. So, pico de gallo, you can spice it up with a little bit of jalapeno pepper. That is not too spicy. If you spiced your meat already with chili, I wouldn't add a chili in your pico de gallo, but it's up to yourself. Then we're done. Then we put that in a nice mixing bowl. Red onion. We're gonna take a half and we're gonna dice this onion in very small brunoise. So we can add this to our salsa. And like I said, we didn't spice our meat, so I'm gonna take a little piece of a jalapeno pepper. I'll remove the seeds, not to have too much heat, and cut that in very small dice. And then we start with our seasoning. And for our seasoning, we need cilantro or coriander. Take the stems out and chop it. It doesn't have to be chopped too fine. You can chop it quite coarse. Voila. And for our seasoning, a good dash of fleur de sel. Nice cracked black pepper from the mill. And a nice lime juice to give it that tang. Voila. And then we'll mix this nicely with a spoon so we can use it later to fill our taco. So after finishing our pico de gallo tomato salsa, we're gonna do a quick guacamole, which is to fill. For guacamole, I prefer to use a nice ready and ripe avocado, and you scoop out the meat and make sure that the peel is off. It has to be really, really ripe. If it's not ripe, it's not worth making a guacamole because it will not be nice. We add about a teaspoon of sour cream, add some lime juice for a nice tang. Again, some fresh coriander, which we chop very finely so it can give maximum flavor to the guacamole. And then we add in a little bit of a chopped onion. Cut the onion very fine. For seasoning, nice pinch of fleur de sel inside and some black pepper. And then we'll crush our avocado with a fork. And if it's nice and ripe, it should not be a problem. You see how smooth the avocado becomes. And we just make sure that it becomes a nice mixture. You can do it in a food processor, then you actually get a very smooth one. I prefer that it's a little bit chunky and the onions get a nice crunch into it. Guacamole ready. I chopped earlier a little bit of iceberg salad, which we put in ice water to make it nice and crunchy. And then we're gonna finish it off with a little bit of sour cream, which I'm gonna put in a makeshift piping bag. And we just make a small cone that later on we can use together with our sour cream. We fill it up and it's just more so that we can spray that or pipe that sour cream nicely over our tacos. And keep this also on the side. Let's have a look how the beef short rib is doing in the oven. Oof. You can smell the beef short rib. And look how fantastic this looks. It has been braising now for 5 hours, juicy, and it falls off the bone. Our beef short rib. You need about 4 taco shells. I buy the taco shells ready. You can make them yourself, but it's a lot of work. And I think the quality that you buy is absolutely excellent. They are nice and crunchy. Just before you use them, put them in the oven for 2-3 minutes so they get a little bit of a crunch extra on that. So let's see the beef short rib, how this one is coming out. Because what we need to do, you can see it's falling off the bone and the bones are staying here in the liquid. You see that? So on the beef short rib, we're gonna take the fat off because the fat is what we don't need. And that we only get that delicious meat. And we're gonna cut this into small pieces. And you can smell the dry rub on it, that it gives that extra flavor, nice and hot. Smells absolutely divine. So we cut the short rib in small pieces. Put this into a mixing bowl. And this is not all, remember, it has been braising in orange juice, carrot, sweet peppers, and we're gonna use this braising juice to mix it with the beef to make it even more juicy. To finish off the beef tacos, we put the tacos in the oven for a few minutes so they are nice and warm. Your beef. Beef inside the taco, and don't be shy, because if people are hungry, you need to give it a decent portion. Some extra juice to make it even more better. Then we add a little bit of crisp salad. Top it off with our pico de gallo. A nice dollop of guacamole. And then remember the little piping bag with our sour cream. And you put some sour cream on top and finish it off with fresh cilantro. I think this looks stunning. And this is ready, and these are my tacos.
This is so much. Oh my God.
Speechless. For today's recipe, please go to www.passionforcooking.co.za. Join us on Facebook page, which is Passion for Cooking. Thank you so much for joining us today. Till next time, bye bye. Cut diamonds.